Friends, today we are going to start a new topic of chapter 9, that is a factors affecting the requirement of fixed capital. So these are the factors. Let's see one after one. So first is the nature of business. The type of business has a very much effect on his capital requirements. So as for the example, if you are concerned is with the trading, at that time you need to invest you need to invest a low amount in fixed asset as compared to manufacturing business. So if you are in business of manufacturing, you have to invest more amount in fixed capital, and if you are in trading business, you have to invest less amount in fixed capital. So why? Because they do not have to purchase plant and machinery or land and building or something, so some things which are required for the manufacturing. Next is a scale of operation. So if in the case of large organization is there, at that time higher scale is needed. At that time they want big plants, they want more space and etc., and therefore their requirement of investment in fixed asset will be also high in comparison to small business organization. Next is choice of technique. So some organization are going for the capital incentive technique, or some are going for the labor intensive technique. So if you are going for capital incentive technique, at that time you need a higher investment in plant and machinery, because they are depending on less on manual labors, and their requirement of capital will be also higher. If you are going for a labor intensive, at that time organization have to invest less in fixed asset, and hence their fixed capital requirement will be also low. Next is a technological upgradation. So here we can see that our business environment is all the time changes. It is a very dynamic. So in certain industries, like the assets are there become outdated very soon. So at that time they need to replace it very faster. So it require higher investment in fixed assets. Like you can give example of computers are there, they become outdated very soon, in few years only, so they need to be replaced very soon. And when we are talking about the furniture, at that time it is not become outdated for in short period of time. So organization has which assets are chance to become outdated soon, they require higher fixed capital investment, because they have to replace the asset more time in comparison to other fixed asset, like which are not there is no chance to get outdated very soon, like furniture. Next is a growth prospects. If there is a more chance of growth of the organization, at that time they need more investment in fixed capital. Even we are expecting such kind of growth in future, so company may go for creating higher capacity to meet their anticipated higher capacity demand, and that's why they have to invest more amount in fixed capital. And a large amount should be invest in the fixed asset, and consequently what happened, they must have a larger amount of fixed capital. So growth prospect is also affecting the requirement of fixed capital. If there is a chance of growth, you need more capital. More fixed capital is there because you need more fixed assets, because your business is going to grow, and it require more fixed capital, more assets. Next is diversification. Company may go for the diversification in its operation for various reasons, and with this diversification, fixed capital requirement is also increasing. Like if you are in textile industry and you are diversifying and you are starting the cement manufacturing also, and obviously this will increase your investment in fixed capital also. Next is a financing alternatives. So financing alternative, here Here we are trying to see in the financial market, and if we are getting the assets on a lease, at that time it will be good alternative for us. We don't have to purchase the fixed asset, and our investment in fixed asset will be less. So it is when possible when an asset is taken on a lease. So at that time we have to pay the lease amount, that is a rental amount only, and by doing so we are avoiding the huge amount which are required to purchase. We are avoiding this and we are taking the advantage of leasing facility, but this facility is not available in every asset. So when we are using this, at that time our fund requirement will be less in the case of fixed asset, and thereby we are reducing our fixed capital requirement. And such a strategy can be used specifically when the risk is very high in the business. Next is level of collaboration. So we can see here certain business organizations are there. They are sharing some facilities with each other, like we have ATM machines are there. So this machine facility, these services are jointly they are using, and they are doing collaboration with each other. And this is a feasible when the scale of operation of each business is they are not they do not have a sufficient to make full use of their facility. At that time what happened, they are doing such a kind of collaboration, and it will reduce the level of investment in fixed assets. So the each of the participating organization have to do less amount, have to invest less amount in the fixed capital. All right, so these points are there like that way. So you can easily remember this point with the help of this word, that is called unfold CG. So what is meaning of U? U is technological upgradation. N means nature of business. F means financing alternatives. O means scale of operation. L means level of collaboration. D means diversification. C means choice of technique. And G means growth prospects. I hope you understand, friends. Thank you very much.